The Monterey Coast has always been an artist haven. Its epic scenic beauty and the romantic, quiet nature of its small towns have inspired artists and writers for many years.
Hello and welcome to Hidden Stories of Monterey. I'm Eric Palmer. In this episode, we're going to explore Monterey's literary history. Let's start right here on Cannery Row, named after John Steinbeck's celebrated novel, where its atmosphere and people inspired his stories and characters.
Before Monterey was the tourist destination it is today, it was an industrial town with fishermen and busy canneries. 18 canneries lined Ocean View Avenue through the 30s and 40s, processing millions of pounds of fish and employing thousands each year. Monterey was sardine capital of the world. Nobel Prize-winning author John Steinbeck lived here in Monterey and Pacific Grove, and the street ignited his imagination. He immortalized the lovable eccentrics who gathered along the street in his stories. Cannery Row and Sweet Thursday were two huge hits and put Monterey on the map.
Cannery Row in Monterey in California is a poem, a stink, a grating noise, a quality of light, a tone, a habit, a nostalgia, a dream.
Perhaps the most famous site is Pacific Biological Laboratories. Steinbeck was best friends with the marine biologist who lived and worked here, Ed Ricketts. Ricketts inspired the character of Doc in his novels. The lab is called Western Biological Laboratories in the book. Doc was the smartest and the most charismatic and admired resident of the row.
Doc would listen to any kind of nonsense and change it for you to a kind of wisdom. His mind had no horizon. Everyone who knew him was indebted to him, and everyone who thought of him thought next, I really must do something nice for Doc.
The simple premise of the book has a group of Cannery Row denizens coming together to throw Doc a party. Across the street sits the Wing Chun building, which inspired Lee Chung's grocery in the book. Wan Yi owned the Wing Chun Market in 1918 and is said to inspire the character. His family still owns the building. Lee Chung was a shrewd businessman, but generous to the characters.
Lee Chung's grocery, while not a model of neatness, was a miracle of supply. It was small and crowded, but within its single room, a man could find everything he needed or wanted to live and be happy.
The 80-year-old La Ida Cafe building is next door. In the novel, the building was a bordello and bar where the characters would frequent. The Bear Flag building down the street is where its workers were said to have lived. Cannery Row remains a destination for people interested in both the actual history of the area and the fictionalized setting of John Steinbeck's novels. You can find one of Steinbeck's homes in Old Monterey. Soon after the publication of Cannery Row, Steinbeck and his family moved. He loved the house, calling it a house I have wanted since I was a kid. Another literary site is the Robert Louis Stevenson House in Old Monterey. This beautiful adobe was built in the 1830s and eventually became a hotel. Scottish novelist and travel writer Robert Louis Stevenson stayed here in the fall season of 1879. Some say he was inspired to write his classic novel, Treasure Island, while walking along the Monterey Peninsula coast. He wrote about Monterey during his trip, saying,
"Even in quiet weather, the low, distant, thrilling roar of the Pacific Ocean hangs over the adjacent country like smoke over a battle. These long beaches are enticing to an idle man. It would be hard to find a walk more solitary and at the same time more exciting to the mind. On no other coast that I know shall you enjoy in calm, sunny weather such a spectacle of ocean's greatness, such a beauty of changing color, or such degrees of thunder in the sound.
The most unique writer's home on the peninsula certainly belongs to Robinson Jeffers. Jeffers was an American poet, known for his work about the Central Coast. He built this house himself in 1919, which he called Tor House. The adjacent tower was built for his wife. It was built from stones collected along Carmel's coastline. He would write many of his acclaimed poems here, looking out over the rugged bay.
Point Joe has teeth and has torn ships. It has fierce and solitary beauty. Walk there all day. You shall see nothing that will not make part of a poem.
Though much has changed since Stevenson, Jeffers, and Steinbeck lived here, it is easy to imagine the peninsula in their day. Many of the historic buildings remain intact, the coastline has been preserved, and their writings remain to remind us of the bustle, diversity, and beauty of the Monterey Peninsula. That epic scenic beauty and the romantic quiet charm still remain, attracting writers and artists to this day.
Visit Monterey and the writings by Steinbeck, Stevenson, Jeffers, and more. Or visit us in person to see the sites that inspired so many. We also have some great museums that will teach you about literary history and more. Join us next time for Hidden Stories of Monterey. For a complete listing of episodes, visit youtube.com/cityofmonterey.